Hi, in this new tutorial, we will learn how to mirror a sub-object element in a spline shape. And in the second part, we will learn how to add vertices to an already existing spline. So first, the mirror. Here I have this object. All of these are one object. It has three spline sub-object level elements. Let's say I want to mirror this spline here. So first I select the object, then go to spline, select the spline, and here go to mirror. By default you should see the mirror horizontally checked. If I click mirror, as you can see, the object is mirrored, and it is mirrored based on its local bounding box. So imagine there is a box here, and the geometric middle of this bounding box. So this is the reference, let's say reference axis of the mirror. I can click here, mirror vertically, and mirror the spline vertically. The third choice is mirror both. That means it will mirror the object vertically then horizontally in a one operation like this. I will go back to horizontally, and let's say you want to create a copy, not just mirror the shape. So you can click here, copy, and you can click mirror, and we have this copy now. I can move it, and I will delete it. I can click vertically and mirror, so I have a copy here. So but let's say that I don't want the reference to be the geometric middle of this. I want let's say the middle of this segment here to be the reference for the mirror. So what I can do, I can use this option here, about pivot. So first I need to go to the object level, go to hierarchy, affect pivot only, and place the pivot point where I want it. Now in my case, now it is located correctly because it is in the middle, but let's say I will move it a little bit. I will put it here. I go back to spline, choose this one, and click about pivot, horizontal, and as you can see, it is mirroring around the new position of the mirror, of the pivot point, sorry. And here this is the very vertical, and both. And of course I can click copy now and do a mirror, an horizontal mirror, and create a copy at the same time around this pivot point axis this way. I can go back here and place the pivot point using the midpoint snap, turn on snap, and place it here. Now go back to spline and choose this spline and do a mirror again. So now I have a mirror around this midpoint here, this pivot point which is here. I can choose all of them, choose vertical. Remember to keep those options on, and then a mirror, and we have this. Now if I add an extrude modifier, I can have this shape. Okay, now for the second part, let's say I want to add some vertices, some additional vertices. So I can go to vertex, and look for refine, and then click anywhere. Now here snap is on and I have this midpoint, so I can place a vertex here in the middle. I can turn off the snap and place my vertex anywhere I like. I can add as many vertices as I want. Now I have this new shape. You can also do the same thing in the segment sub object level. Also you have this refine option, so I can click here, here, here. You can right click to turn off the refine button, and then you can do whatever you want with the shape, change its form. I can convert this to smooth type. So yeah, basically that's it for this tutorial. I hope you like it, and if you do, please subscribe to the channel and press the like button, and see you next time. Thank you.